On January 19, 1972, young Rick Reuschel stepped into a heady situation in the Windy City, contention. That afternoon, the Chicago Cubs defeated the San Francisco Giants 7-6 on a Glenn Beckert double off of Jerry Johnson that drove in Don Kessinger for the winning run. The victory left the Cubs in third place in the old National League West, but only 2.5 games behind the division-leading Cincinnati Reds. Along the way, the Giants chased Cubs starter Bill Hand with two outs in the fourth, and that's where Reuschel came into play. Taking the bump for the first time in the major leagues, the big lad from Quincy, Illinois, struck out the fearsome Bobby Bonds to end the inning. Art Shamsky pitch hit for Reuschel in the bottom of the frame, and the youngster's debut was done. As it happened, the initial performance was out of character for Reuschel, and also a predictor of things to come. On one hand, Reuschel had never been much of a strikeout pitcher, having never recorded as many as 100 Ks in any of his three major league seasons. But on the other, he was good enough on the mound that the Cubs made him their third-round choice out of Western Illinois University in the 1970 Major League Baseball draft. And, well, he fairly well dominated the Chicago farm system, watching his ERA fall from 3.53 to 2.31 to 1.32 as he climbed from low A ball to the AAA Wichita Arrows. And then, from the first appearance in June through the end of the 1972 season, Reuschel went 10-8, 2.93 for the Cubs as they climbed into second place on August 23rd and stayed there for the rest of the season. Unfortunately for the Wrigley faithful, the Reds pulled away, so far so that the Cubs finished 11 games out of the money that October. Still, they had one heck of a consolation prize in the 23-year-old Reuschel, who had pretty much established himself as the staff ace. That next spring, Topps granted Reuschel his first baseball card, number 482 in the 1973 set. Thanks to his strong half-season showing, Reuschel avoided the usual indignity of sharing his rookie card with other players, and is instead shown in his Cubs road jersey with Shea Stadium looming in the background. The cute Cubby logo even peers over Reuschel's right shoulder, coupled with the softish, oversized physique that would eventually earn him his Big Daddy moniker. The cuddly mascot and Reuschel's grin makes the pitcher seem like a big teddy bear. Pity the fool batter who might have been fooled. For no matter how friendly he looked, and for no matter how few strikeouts he tossed, Reuschel was poised to step into the upper echelons of Major League Baseball pitchers for the next couple of decades. Consider, from 1973 to 80, Reuschel went 115-106, 3.46 for the Cubs team that combined to go 533-600. He helped the New York Yankees get to the 1981 World Series after they traded Doug Bird for him in June of that year. After a rotator cuff injury that forced him to miss 1982 and convinced the Yankees to leave him for dead in 1983, Reuschel came back to the latter that season. The Cubs gave him up too after 1984, but the Pittsburgh Pirates gave him another chance, and he repaid them by going 14-8, 2.2 ERA at the age of 36, to win the Comeback Player of the Year award. Traded by the Bucks to San Francisco for Scott Medvin and Jeff Robinson in August of 1987, Reuschel helped the Giants to a postseason berth. Then in 1988 and 1989, Rick the Geezer put it all together again to post a combined 36-19 record with 9 complete games. And did I mention that Rick also combined with older brother Paul Reuschel to shut out the Los Angeles Dodgers on August 21, 1975? No? Well, he did, and it remains the only sibling-authorized combined shutout in Major League history. Now, after the 1989 season when he was 40, things came apart pretty quickly for Rick Reuschel, but his legend had been written by then. When he hung up his spikes for good in 1991, Reuschel's career record stood at 214-191, complemented by a 3.3 ERA and a 114 ERA plus. All that was good for 69.5 career WAR, Baseball Reference version. And if you flip over to Jaws, Jay Jaffe's nifty all-in-one stat, Reuschel checks in as the 48th best starting pitcher of all time. For reference, there are 65 starters in the Hall of Fame. Does that mean Reuschel definitely should be in Cooperstown? Well, I don't know. I think he probably belongs, even if his name doesn't send shivers down your spine, and you're more likely to find him in the common bins than a PSA holder. But the man almost certainly deserved more than two measly votes he received in his lone year on the ballot in 1997. What's a teddy bear got to do to get a little respect anyway?
Like our video? Then like our video and subscribe to our channel. WaxpackGods.com